It's a very tiny one. So today we are entering another part of Saligaon, and this is Tabrawado.
Yes.
Tabrawado. And this is Sulimak. So Sulimak, there is Irfan and there's Bhagyashree. And Hashima will come in soon. Yeah. She was here just now, but I had a problem with my camera, so we're starting again.
Yeah.
Irfan, tell us your story. Tell us.
Before I tell the story, I'm really happy to be here, you know, in Saligaon, because I've seen like people are really active. A lot of things are happening. Like you're conducting
online market. It's all in the mind. I think that can be replicated anywhere, but the online world is helping to build these links, you know.
Yeah, replicated. That's the right word. I mean, these things have to be replicated. That is exactly what we are doing. See, she's an environmentalist.
Yeah.
I've been a filmmaker, so as a filmmaker, I was a creative head and a strategic content head with the TV channels and all.
Wow.
That.
Wow.
So that is where I learned like all this marketing skill, because with creativity.
You all work really hard in marketing all your.
That's what. See, we came here with the intention of like having like a village life and also like, you know, promoting sustainable lifestyle in Goa. Because back in Bombay also, like when everyone bought a house, I bought a farm, you know. So
I see.
Where I used to rush every weekend.
How far?
Around 100 kilometers from Bombay.
Which?
Neral. Yeah, I still have that farm.
I see.
Yeah, with mangoes and this.
So farm. What is your offering here at the moment? I can see garden tools. I can see
some seeds.
Yeah, seeds. Offering, that's what. So we are trying to promote sustainable lifestyle in Goa. Now, one part of sustainable lifestyle is promoting organic farming.
I see.
Now, one is promoting organic farming, but most important, what we stress everywhere, other markets.
Creating markets.
Because everywhere people talk about like growing your own, or growing this, or government talks, politicians talk. Everybody talks about growing. Where is the market?
Correct.
There's
that small missing link between the production and the consumer is missing.
No, sir. Yes. It is a very big gap. It is a very, very big gap. And I think markets are most important. You know, markets are very, very important. Then only you will grow. No?
Correct.
If there are no, see, there
there's
are
no buyer, sustainability.
There's no sustainability. See, Goa has a lot of problems. I mean, let's not talk about that.
Geography and transport and all that.
No, sir, it's not about topography. Like, it's also about scale. See, agriculture in Goa is totally different from rest of India. No, that is what I tell. Because whenever we talk to
scale, some... Scale.
Yeah, scale, of course. It is, end of the day, it is scale. No? See, anything and everything you try to do. Like see, we are trying to promote like small-time farmers.
Yeah.
You know, you may be growing like some 17 bananas, some 5 limes, or like, you know, some small vegetable patch and all that. Now, we can't go there and procure that. No? Neither can they come
Correct.
Here.
It's not viable.
There has to be scale. Again, everybody does the same thing. Tamri Bhaji, Bhende, Mudo, this, whatever. You're also doing the same thing. Little Magnified, she's also doing the same thing. So, there's no innovation. See, we have like maybe like the farmer's mentality. What we need are the agriculturists. You know, so that is what we're trying to infuse in people's mind, you know, like, and plus, like, see, try to understand the segregation. You know, like, see, when there's a corporate, any corporate house, they have finance department, they have operations department, they have logistics department, they have marketing department, they have so many departments. But one farmer, you expect him to do everything.
Yeah.
He has to do the production, he has to manage the farm, he has to do marketing. Is it worth?
Very, very interesting concept.
Yeah, see, she could be very good at production, but she might be zero at marketing.
Yeah.
Or she could be very good at marketing, but she could be zero at production.
So tell us the range of your products. This is a fascinating discussion. I must come back, because I've come at the wrong time when the light is bad, and it's my fault. But so, I will come back. Yeah. But now, for now, just to give people a hint of what are your range of products.
Yeah. So
why should they come here? In a word,
they should come here. So we have like the complete organic solution. See, earlier there was like everyone was talking about organic farming.
Yeah.
But then there were no solutions.
Yeah.
But now we have, right from immunity boosters to like, you know, pest management and like, you know, this Jeevamrut and, you know, like all the organic manures. We have that. Plus we have seeds. We have microgreen seeds.
What range of seeds?
All the vegetable seeds.
Many.
All.
How many?
Huh?
Varieties?
27 varieties we have.
Wow. List, for instance, roughly?
We have spinach, then there is sunflower, which is locally grown. Tamri Bhaji, Dhabi Bhaji seeds are local. Then local brinjal also we have. And there is plant bean, kuware, bottle gourd, bitter gourd.
Yeah.
Then there is, what else is there? We have this Tamri Bhaji, Tidki Midki, Methi, Shepu is there.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's quite a big range.
Gourds, all gourds and leafies are there. Wow. And carrot. Things like that also are there.
Was there jaggery? No.
Yeah, we have is high curcuma and turmeric powder, and this is garam masala done by one Kankun lady. So it is not spicy. It can be used for raw, susar, for simple chicken recipes also. So that is there.
Very interesting.
Then we have locally grown black pepper, cashews are
what there. A collection, yeah.
Yeah.
And this this slick packaging. Slick packaging is.
Yeah, we do packaging. No,
this one is the Roselle powder, so that is color-free drink. Like Roselle traditionally is used to make color-free jam and lot of recipes here, but there things can be the like this can be also done. So it is an encouragement also and solution also for the people who are looking for something cool and little different.
I see.
But without any additives.
That's a big company. Basically, if you see around, there are no brands. So that is one thing we are very strict about.
I see. Like,
you know, yeah, we don't keep brands. We are trying to promote all the locals.
Fascinating.
Yeah. Yeah, locals. So and if you see there are no, but this particular company,
yeah,
just to supply some organic vegetables and all from Bombay, you know, so they have like a big network and all that. And this is their own brand. So we had kept few, like I mean, solely that, you know, the casual.
Irfan, what are your experiences in marketing in Goa? You've tried many things and you've been in different places. I think first in Margao.
Yeah, Margao, marketing like experience as in say like now in the pandemic, I mean everything is
dislocated. Correct.
See what
that is acceptable.
Yeah. No, marketing was good. So what we did, no, like with our markets, like if you see, look at a lot of exhibitions happening.
Yeah.
That is 30%, 40%, 80% margins and this whatever, you know, yeah. But you won't really believe in that, no, because you just go, because if you even if it is like 80%, ultimately you'll see the cost price, how much is for you, t-shirt or whatever.
Yeah.
Plus, I mean, this guy they spent so much money, you know, in exhibiting, like building up the place, then ultimately they charge the vendor.
Yeah.
So vendor in return will charge the customer.
Okay.
So the people, I mean customers just come, they just see the place and they go. Nobody believes in that.
Yeah.
What we did is we gave the space free. Now when I give you the space free, if you are selling something for 100,
I see.
If you are selling something for 100 some elsewhere, you have to sell here for 90, you know?
Correct.
90 or 80, because I'm not charging you anything, you know?
Yeah.
So that is how, and we kept the...
Where was this?
Margao.
Where?
Margao Ravindra Bhavan.
I see.
Yeah, yeah. So we used to
The Sulimak market,
yeah,
I've heard of that.
Yeah, we used to do a...
And Sulimak stands for?
Sustainable Lifestyle Market.
Sustainable Lifestyle.
Yeah. So that is how we got, then people started coming to see, then they started coming with the money, then they started buying. Yeah. So we had something called a community stall, you know, where, I mean, if you're not taking the table, you could keep your stuff and like, you know, we could sell. So we used to do.
You all organized the markets actually. How many markets?
I don't know, sir, don't know the number. So now these were the monthly markets.
I see.
Now, see.
You allowed to pay them, Ravindra Bhavan, or no?
See, initially, yes. Initially, yes. But then they saw us like doing the calls and all, and then later on they didn't charge.
I see.
Yeah.
You are willing to work with someone who has the space, who is willing to organize something like this?
That is exactly what we are doing, sir. So, like, we are looking at teams, because see, physically we can't be everywhere, no?
Correct.
And because of pandemic, we got stuck. We are selecting teams, that we are, like, even now, like, there are appointments, we are unable to go there,
yeah,
because we don't have a big team. What we want to do is set up a market elsewhere and then let the team run.
Outsource, self-sustaining.
Yeah, self-sustaining agents, so we don't even take money from that. Suppose you have a team, suppose in Shivalik or say Moira, wherever, you know, like we'll set up the whole market for you, okay, give the whole concept and we'll participate 2-3 times, this whatever.
I see.
And then like whatever the collection, now it all depends on you.
Yeah.
How much you want to, whether you want to charge them, you have to charge something.
Yeah.
Because free really doesn't work, we have seen.
Free works for us in the Saligaon Institute. They are paying back, they are paying back in terms of labor.
See,
in terms of cleaning up.
It's a nice small community, so it works.
Yeah, it works. And we have a restriction of village only.
So that also works.
So there is a natural filter. That's a natural filter. Otherwise, you'll get any Tom, Dick and Harry coming in and you know.
Yeah, that's what happened. I mean, then like, you know, you come with a small. See, if I charge 2,000, you want to cover that 2,000.
Yeah.
But if I'm giving you free, you'll come and sham over there.
Correct.
You know, you'll sit on the mobile, you'll get some stupid stuff trying to force that, and you know,
correct,
and you're not really
correct
pushing. So anything that is
free. Interesting.
So anyways, so like what the question you asked me. So when we give there, so it all depends on the team over there, how much they want to charge. They want to charge 10%, they want to charge like 100 rupees, 200. And that money what is collected goes to the welfare of the market.
I see.
You know, in form of like your light bill, is
correct,
whether it's an individual or some institute or some organization. They're spending, you know. Plus like we give like snacks. Even though we give the market, do the markets free, we give some sort of snack because some people really can't afford, sir.
Correct.
You know, they really can't afford. So we give some sort of snacks like tea and this whatever. So all this, so there are expenses, labor cost, table.
Of course.
Yeah. So all these things are there. So likewise, if there is a team, you know.
Who is the ideal team you like to partner with? Who is your message meant for? Who are the people who should be approaching you? Schools, institutions,
No, schools, sir, now see, like what has happened in the last few months, school is closed, churches were closed, everything was closed. Like churches, okay, like, you know, if churches have like, their own team, good. They have space, they have everything. And classes.
Yeah, they are willing to give also because.
Yeah, yeah, they are willing to give. Only thing, it has to be interior. Because exterior means the rains, again,
yeah,
you have
see.
To put like shade on. That's a cost. So, our idea is you have to keep the cost low, then only you can give the product at the lesser.
How long you've been doing this?
Now, before the pandemic, we were doing the markets. It's 3.5 years we are here.
Yeah,
we are here in Goa. You know, yeah, we've been doing that.
Very interesting idea. I do hope it catches on.
Yes, I mean, that is what our whole motive is.
What are
the
best products you recommend for home customers?
Like home customers, see, sir, yeah, like you said, like, you know, we don't have wide range.
Okay.
We have very few, but everything has a story. Like, for example, this turmeric, you know. Like the regular turmeric will have like 0.5% curcumin, you know, 1%. This has 6%.
I
the
see.
Highest in the world is 9%.
I see.
Which is 2,400 a kg. We are selling this for 800 a kg.
I see.
You know, which is almost at par. So if
I
you
see.
Are using it for the medicinal purpose, you can, of course, you can put it in food. But then it's a luxury.
I
know?
See.
So then, like, you know, this masala is there which we like. I mean, we want to brand this now. Because it's like some Kankol lady.
I
doing.
See.
Very nice masala.
And what's it priced at?
This is 8,400 grams.
I
yeah.
see.
Yeah. Yeah. So likewise, this, then there are honeys. Now this honeys, there are different flavors. These are not infused with flavors.
I see.
This box, like see, that's it, that is what's there. Outside there are big orchids, no sir?
Yeah.
We'll be doing like this medicinal project.
Correct.
Like. So if it is tulsi, they have like this huge orchids of tulsi.
I see.
Acres and acres of tulsi. So they keep these boxes there. So you get tulsi honey.
I see.
You get neem honey. You get like, you know, multifloral honey, you know. So likewise, we have like this honeys. Then even this pickle, it is of the same rhizomes.
I see.
Of this, you know, so it is high curcumin, it's good for health. Very less oil. So these are all organically.
What know, pickle
so,
is that?
Turmeric rhizomes.
I see.
Raw turmeric. Yeah.
Price tag?
It is 200 grams for 180.
I see. Yes.
180, no?
Yeah.
Very interesting.
So like, yeah.
Turmeric pickle.
So then, yeah, this is again, I mean, one lady, big prawn, she is doing this, you know, so this needs marketing. You know,
that's what
pickle,
prawn
pickle.
Prawn.
It's not balcham.
Okay,
it's pickle.
I see.
You know, yeah, and she's used like big prawn because she's a lady. I mean, who's just doing it for passion.
Yeah.
You know, yeah.
And what's the price of that?
This is 500.
500.
500. But she's used like bigger. So likewise, I mean, lot. Then this ghee is there.
I see.
All the products are gone.
I see.
You know, like see, and but see, we are sticking to promote.
Any price list? Any?
Yeah, we have.
If you can send me, I'll be grateful.
Yeah. Yeah. So only things I see now, like, okay, we are very sentimental about promoting Goans and Goa and all that, but you as a person, you need like other things also, now like these raisins.
Yep.
Raisins are not from Goa.
Yeah, of course.
Whatever is not here. I mean,
no, that I think I don't have any big hang-ups about that, but.
No, I'm saying something. So one more important thing, like you, when we are saying you're promoting organic farming, that is what we're doing, kitchen gardening and all. See, we have like this kind of, we have done the mixes. Right from planting, if you want to plant something, to for the plant growth, to immunity booster, to like yielding, at every stage, for every plant, we have customized the formulas, you know. So you name the plant, we have like a solution for it. Like this is for flowering, you know, like at certain stage you need like certain boosters, you know? So we have those kind of things, you know. So we have done like mixes, then we have like farmyard menu, all those kind of food. Now, what is important? Creating the market. So, yeah, that is the reason why this is started, because you just can't be growing, no? We're trying to create markets. And we would want you to come and sell, you know? Because for us, it is really not the correct economics, selling this vegetable. But when you come as a customer, we want you to give you variety. Because till the time the markets, people don't realize this and don't get the kind of support we need. We can't call some farmer and make him hang around.
Correct.
No?
It's not worth his while.
Yeah, it's not worth his while. Exactly. So that is the reason why, like, see this chikus. These are from some big family.
I see.
You know, Bandekar from Sange.
I see.
You know, so these are organic. Now this lime come again from them, I think so.
I see.
Then the other local, morning, like, there were people.
I see.
You know, so, boya.